If you are a dog owner, you surely want your pup to be happy, healthy, and live a long, fulfilling life. But sometimes we do things that can potentially harm our furry friends. In this video, we will talk about 16 common mistakes dog owners unknowingly make when they are caring for their canine companions. Number 16. Segregation from the pack. Dogs are pack animals. When they are in the wild, they do everything together and they are loyal to the pack. For a domestic dog, you are their pack and family. If you are constantly pushing your dog away or ignoring them when they try to climb in your lap and give you kisses, you're not only depriving them of affection, but going against their nature. Dogs need to be around their loved ones. Isolating them from their pack, you in this case, will eventually result in depression. Make sure that you give them a lot of attention when you can. If you work longer hours, it is a good idea to have someone stop in to check on your pet. You could also take them to a doggy daycare now and then so they can socialize with other animals and humans while you are away. Number 15. Letting your dog stick its head out of a moving vehicle. Dogs love to ride with their head out the car window. Not only do they like the feel of the cool wind in their fur, but they love the many scents they receive as they experience new locations. Dogs are known for their ability to air scent, and moving air carries a lot of interesting smells. You want your dog to have the best life possible, but allowing a dog's head to be exposed on the road can be dangerous. Branches, rocks, or other debris could collide with the animal's head. The wind also carries dust and foreign objects that could harm your dog's eyes. Ear damage is another concern. High wind speed causes so much ear flapping that it can result in swelling and scarring of their soft ear flaps, which can lead to a lifetime of pain. Even worse, the dog might feel the impulse to jump out of a moving car. Few people would even think of allowing their kids to hang heads out of a moving vehicle, but many still allow their dogs to risk serious injury by doing so. Number 14. Giving your dog bones. Bones are a good source of nutrients and other minerals and help satisfy your dog's appetite. Chewing stimulates saliva enzymes, helps treat plaque buildup on teeth, and prevents gum disease in your dog. However, many vets believe it just isn't worth the risk of serious injuries to give your dog a bone. Giving dogs a real bone could be deadly. Whether it's from beef, poultry, pork, or fish, a bone can cause your canine to choke, or the bone could shatter and puncture their esophagus, stomach, or intestines. Your dog could even break a tooth, get a tongue or mouth injury, or have an obstruction that could require surgery. If you'd like to give your pup a bone to chew, it's important to follow certain rules so your dog can enjoy their bone safely. First of all, avoid giving your pup cooked bones of any kind, as they can break and splinter into tiny sharp pieces that can cut your dog's mouth, throat, or digestive organs. Secondly, make sure to give your dog bones that are longer than the length of their muzzle. This will make it impossible for your dog to swallow or splinter them into small, sharp pieces. No bone is too big, but there are certainly bones that are too small. Number 13. Using physical punishment. It's important to discipline your dog, but physical punishment should never be the way to do it. It's animal abuse, and it doesn't work. It actually does the opposite of what you want. Reward-based training is much more effective than physical punishment. Reward-based training helps build trust and a strong bond between the dog and their owner. It encourages a dog to behave in a desired way. But when an owner uses physical punishment, a dog can concentrate only on one thing. It hurts, and I don't like it. It brings distrust of humans. Think about it. Do you like getting hit, or do you like rewards? Your dog is no different than you. If you're ever feeling like the discipline is getting out of your control, it's time to hire a professional trainer or ask for assistance from your family members or friends. Remember, training your dog is a constant, exhausting process in the beginning, but the time and energy it will save down the road for the rest of your dog's life is immeasurable. Number 12. Not keeping your dog stimulated. Dogs need as much mental and physical stimulation as people do. You should be regularly walking your dog and making sure they're exposed to something new every now and then. Your dog not only needs exercise, but they also need to be exposed to different smells, sights, and sounds. It makes their brain work better. Let them watch the squirrels, sniff the neighbor's dog, and take them to new routes to explore new areas. Training your dog to perform tricks and putting some treats in action is also a great way to create mental stimulation and prevent anxiety and stress-related issues. If your dog gets bored, they'll find a way to entertain themselves, which can mean destroying some of your personal belongings. Number 11. choosing the wrong collar. As a responsible dog owner, it's important that you choose the right type of collar for your canine. There are several kinds of collars, and you need to choose one that best suits the needs and character of your pooch, and it should have a place to attach their identification tag. A flat buckle collar. This is the most basic piece of dog-related equipment, a plain collar that snaps or buckles closed. This is a great option for dogs that don't pull on the leash and aren't prone to slipping out of their collar. A body harness. If your canine is a puller or likes to explore as far as they can reach, using a harness might be a better option. Collars can seriously injure your pet's throat if it pulls too hard on its leash, but that's not a problem with pulling on a harness. A front clip harness in particular, where the leash attaches to your dog's front, redirects your dog back towards you if they start to strain or pull. This is an effective method to avoid leash pulling. Special collars for dog training. You might not want to use these types of collars if you have a young puppy, since they're designed for behavioral training. Don't forget to check the tightness every once in a while, especially while your dog is still growing. Also, dogs, just like people, can put on weight over time. Number 10. Not making socialization a priority. We can't stress enough just how important it is to socialize your canine. It helps create a better behaved dog who is more enjoyable to be around. It is also much better for their health and well-being. Dogs who aren't properly socialized will have a fear of new or unusual circumstances. This results in the release of adrenaline hormones that increase blood pressure, as well as heart and respiration rates. It's the whole fight or flight response thing that you've heard about, but for long periods of time, which can be damaging for your poor doggy. Number 9. Yelling when your dog misbehaves. Yelling is another thing you should never do when disciplining your canine. It doesn't work, just like physical punishment doesn't. You're just freaking out your pet, especially when you are upset about something that has happened a while ago. Your dog will not only get scared, but they will be very confused as well. Number 8. Neglecting breed-specific characteristics. It's important to remember that every dog breed has different needs. Some breeds require specific grooming regimens, and others have predispositions to certain health issues. Pushed-in face breeds such as pugs, bulldogs, Pomeranians, and boxers are extremely prone to heat stroke due to their narrow airways and nostrils. Some long-haired breeds such as huskies or Alaskan Malamute have very thick coats and need extra care if kept in tropical climates. If poodles or other curly-haired dog breeds aren't groomed often enough, their hair will become matted over time, which will irritate their skin. Always do your research before you get a dog so that you know how to best take care of them. Number 7. Bringing puppies to a dog park. Believe it or not, taking young puppies to dog parks is a bad idea. First of all, young puppies don't have all the vaccinations, which means they are susceptible to diseases and infections. Secondly, not every dog is as friendly as your pooch. Other dogs can be aggressive towards your pup, and many puppies are not comfortable around unknown, dominant dogs. Number 6. Leaving a dog alone in a car. Never, ever leave your dog alone in an enclosed car. According to the National Oceanic and Atmospheric Administration, the temperature inside a vehicle can go up by 20 degrees in under 10 minutes, even if a car is parked in the shade. When it's 90 degrees out, just 10 minutes in a car can be fatal to a dog. Dogs don't sweat like humans, and they overheat much faster than you think. They lack the ability to cool themselves off efficiently, and the consequences of keeping your pup in an enclosed vehicle can be fatal. Number 5. Not securing your dog in the car. People use seatbelts, children use car seats, so why would the case be any different for your dog? If you don't secure your four-legged friend in the car and you end up in a car accident, your dog can get seriously injured or even killed. The good news is that there are many options when it comes to dog safety. There are harness seat belts, zip line harnesses, and different types of carriers. Don't forget to get one that suits your needs. Number 4. Using harsh cleaning products. Many cleaning products used in our homes are toxic to dogs. Even if your dog isn't directly exposed to these products, they may run over a floor that has been mopped and then lick their paws and ingest those toxins. Always check the label. Any product that contains bleach or ammonia is hazardous to animals. Number 3. Letting your dog eat everything. Most people give their dogs human food thinking they are being caring. But giving dogs human food isn't good for them. Your dog's alimentary canal is very different from yours, just as their nutritional requirements are different. Most times, the foods you eat are too fatty, too spicy, or too salty for your canine. Make sure to avoid feeding them human food, even little crumbles from the table. Number 2. You don't take care of your pet's teeth. Like humans, dogs need regular dental care. Their teeth are home to hundreds of bacteria and need to be brushed just like yours do. Make sure to start doing it as soon as you get your dog so that they get used to having their teeth brushed. For most dogs, once brushing becomes a part of their daily routine, they will begin to enjoy and expect it. Brushing 3 times a week is the minimum recommendation to help remove plaque and prevent tartar accumulation. On that note, remember that you need to have your canine's teeth professionally cleaned every 6 months. Number 1. Skipping flea, tick, and worming treatments. Preventative flea, worm, tick, and heartworm treatment is crucial when caring for a dog. Some people believe they can take a break from it during cold winters, but make sure to discuss it with your vet. On that note, remember that heartworm disease is a serious disease that results in heart failure, organ damages, and death in pets. The worms are spread through the bite of a mosquito. Signs of heartworm disease may include a mild persistent cough, reluctance to exercise, fatigue after moderate activity, decreased appetite, and weight loss. Make sure to get your dogs tested for heartworm infection every 12 months.